Bună ziua! Bine ați venit la o emisiune cu un invitat din Canada. Se numește Rom Laplace și Rom Laplace este unul dintre puținii oameni pe care eu îi cunosc care lucrează cu un sistem numit Acutonix. Acutonix vă introduce la ceea ce înseamnă sunetul, vibrația și frecvența sunetului. L-am invitat pe Ron aici să vă povestească un pic, să vă explice ce înseamnă în acest moment, în acest univers al nostru, sunetul și reconectarea noastră la sunetele Universului, la sunetul Mamei Pământ, la sunetul altor planete. Și cum pot fi folosite aceste minunate diapazoane în tratamentul sau terapia prin sunet și avantajele pe care fiecare dintre noi le putem avea reconectându-ne la sunet, vibrație și frecvența lor. Rom Laplace este un prieten drag de câțiva ani pe care l-am cunoscut lucrând cu Dragolo Melchizedek în școala de aducere aminte sau Awakening the Illuminated Heart. Și am avut onoarea să lucrez cu Rom Laplace în acest context. Și spre marea mea bucurie am avut oportunitatea să redescoper cât de minunate sunt și alte tehnici pe care le putem folosi. Aceste tehnici sunt noi pentru cei din România și am să-l las pe Rom să vă explice mai mult de cât ce perioadă de timp lucrează cu sunetele, cu aceste tehnici ale Acutonix și în același timp să vă povestească cum această nouă, să numim, disciplină sau terapie poate să lucreze cu alte terapii și alte tehnici, alte sisteme. I would like to introduce you tonight Rom Laplace. He's a very dear friend from Canada. I had the honor to meet Rom Laplace through Dragolo Melchizedek School, School of Remembering, during our preparation for the Awakening of the Illuminated Heart workshop. And it was a privilege to reconnect with someone that discovered on his own this wonderful school of Acutonix, a school and a knowledge, a science that is connecting all of us to the sound. And the vibration, the frequency of the sound of Mother Earth, of the sun, of other planets, and it's helping all of us to understand how we can reconnect to who we are and what we are made of. And I would like to also allow Ron to explain to us how wonderful it is for all of us not only to work with these techniques and help ourselves heal, help ourselves understand, as I said, better who we are, but also how we can connect this therapy and techniques with other practices that people may have and help each one of us to return to our essence. So what I'll do, I'll allow Ron now to introduce himself and to tell you a little bit more about the history of how he became to practice this.
Thank you, Michelle.
Welcome, Ron.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be in Bucharest and to share this information with, we've just completed a class now of 5 days with a group of students, and what an honor it is to work with people who are ready to access this information at such a deep level. So a little bit about Acutonix. It's about sound and how sound in our lives is really a part of the creative process and of the creative principle. In the beginning was the word, and that is an expression of what sound offers to the creative process. It was there at the very beginning. So in Acutonix we use that principle, the frequencies and the vibrations of sound, in a very specific way by entering the body at the places known as the meridians and acupuncture points in the body. So Acutonix is actually a marriage of the information that is traditional Chinese medicine with the information of the energy of the heavenly bodies, which means then that you're connecting with vast systems of knowledge from several different areas. Perhaps the place to begin is the foundation of the acutonic system. And that is the tuning fork that is said to be the frequency of Om. And the frequency of Om is very specific. It is the frequency of the Earth in her journey around the Sun, 1 year. And that is a vibrational frequency that can be translated into a sound that we can hear.
You know, I would like to say now that most people that do meditation, they may be familiar with this sound when they obviously chant sometimes Om, or for those that participated in Dropolo's workshop and they go into the tiny space of the heart, and we ask people to say, what is the sound in the tiny space of the heart? And that is more or less the same sound.
Yes.
Vreau să spun că mulți dintre cei care participă în sesiuni de meditație, indiferent de sistem, sunt familiari cu acest frumos sunet de Om. Și în același timp, cei care au participat la workshop-ul lui Dramolo Melchizedek, fie în România, fie cu Dramolo, sunt familiari cu spațiul sacru al inimii. Și spațiul sacru al inimii, și mai precis, este cel mai mic spațiu din inimă. Atunci când facem aceste meditații, îi rugăm pe participanți să descopere sunetul din inima lor, din cel mai mic spațiu. Și acel sunet este exact acest sunet al diapazonului care reprezintă planeta Pământ. Ron, would you like to tell us what is the difference between these tuning forks and the tuning forks that are used for tuning for musical instruments? Deci, întrebarea pentru Ron este dacă poate să ne explice care este diferența dintre aceste diapazoane și diapazoanele care sunt folosite pentru a acorda instrumentele muzicale.
Sure. The tuning forks that many people are familiar with are tuning forks that are precise frequencies of musical notes that allow, for instance, a piano to be tuned. In the past, tuning forks have also been used for the testing of hearing and for other medical purposes. But these tuning forks aren't tuned to precise musical notes. They're tuned to the music of the spheres, the music of the planets and the heavenly bodies, to frequencies that are dictated by the movement of those planets in the cosmos. And those frequencies, for instance, it can be worked out mathematically, like the sound of the Earth in her journey around the Sun. That's a number. So if you know that number, you can adjust it by octaves so that it comes into a sound in the range of human hearing. But this is the same sound that the Aborigines tuned their original didgeridoos to, or the same sound that the drone string of a sitar in India is tuned to. In those cases, they may not have worked that out mathematically. They simply were connecting to the frequency of the Earth herself. So you can come at this scientifically, or you can come at it through the feeling body by connecting to nature. So these frequencies are natural frequencies. And as you say, Michelle, the frequency that is the sound of the Earth, because we are part of her, part of Mother, is something that we connect to when we go into the sacred space and the tiny space of the heart.
Se spune că planeta Pământ are un puls. pulsul planetei pământ, ca o bătaie a inimii pământului, care este acordată cu aceeași bătaie a sistemului nostru solar, ca să fim astfel și cu un puls al întregului univers. It is said that the planet Earth has a pulse, it's like a heartbeat. And the heartbeat of the Earth is in accordance with the heartbeat of our solar system. And our solar system has a heartbeat, the same heartbeat as the universe. That everything is pulsated at once. Is this something that we recognize when we work with the tuning forks?
The sound of Om is universal.
Okay.
And so that sound, when you move into the tiny space in the heart, is a sound that is throughout the universe. It is.
Universe.
Yes, it is directly connected to the universe. But as you know, when you move from the sacred space in the heart into the tiny space, that sound can adjust to a higher frequency, but it will be in an octave of that bass frequency, either one or two, or actually it can be many octaves. There are many people in the world now who are hearing a very high frequency all the time. And some people worry about it because they're not sure what it is. And there's even a name for it, a medical term called tinnitus. And you can, believe it or not, you can get a pill to help solve the issue. My feeling is that this sound that we're hearing is part of a much higher octave of Om that we're connecting to, and that it's representing, the reason we're noticing it is that it is shifting and changing as our DNA changes. The sun, at this moment in time, is changing and shifting. The earth is changing.
Today the sun had a rainbow.
Yes, yes, it did.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Yes. And so, these changes are represented on these bodies that affect us. The sun and the earth directly affect us.
Yeah, that is incredible. Now, what would you say to the people, because there are different levels in aquatonics, there are multiple levels, it's mm-hmm. not only one level, there are, I understand, seven levels, also they have some elective courses, one of them we took with you in this workshop this week in the Fibonacci sequence, which is absolutely amazing. So maybe you want to tell them a little bit about that.
Okay.
Am Lidit Feron să ne vorbesc un pic despre școala de aquatonics și nivelele pe care le are, sunt șapte nivele după am înțeles și o să vă explice un pic și în același timp despre un nou curs care este parte din program, poate fi făcut, este suplimentar, adițional pentru cei care doresc și vorbește exact despre șirul lui Fibonacci și importanța lui în legătură cu sunetul.
Sure. As you say, the aquatonic system consists of seven different levels of information, as well as a number of elective courses, which take certain aspects of work into more detail. And one of those electives I work with directly, called the Fibonacci process. And in the aquatonic system, it's also known as harmonic geometry. So the course that we just completed here in Bucharest was aquatonics level one, which is an introduction into the aquatonic system. And in that introduction, you become familiar with not only the Om forks, these lovely gold ones, but other forks that are actually part of the Earth's vibrational frequency as well. This green one is called Earth Day. So we have a frequency that is 1 year in the Earth's journey around the Sun, and we have a frequency that is 24 hours, the Earth's rotational frequency. And then we have a frequency of the Earth that is called the precession of the equinox, which is a frequency that is almost 26,000 years long. The Mayans know all about this frequency. December 21st, 2012 was the end of a Mayan calendar and the beginning of a new moment in their measuring system of time, of a cycle that is 26,000 years long. It's actually 25,725.
And we are
right
there.
Yeah, we're at the end of one of those.
It's like exciting times.
And then just before we complete that, if it's okay, there are a couple of other forks that are part of this introductory course. These are both frequencies of the moon. We have the new moon, this lovely blue one, and the full moon. And so those are all frequencies that we can connect with directly on the body and work with for certain purposes, certain intentions. That energy can be introduced directly in the body. The reason tuning forks are so powerful is because our body is almost all water. About 80% water. And as you know, water conducts sound at least three times better than air does. So in a body that's all water, when you place a tuning fork on an acupuncture point on the body, that energy moves directly into the meridian system of the body without penetrating with needles.
Like a needle, yeah.
But the sound penetrates as well or even better.
So our body being water mostly, it picks up that frequency of the tuning fork and it transmits it all over throughout the body, receiving information of the planet, of the universe, and so on.
Yes, yes.
Deci, atunci când aplicăm aceste diapazoane pe corpul nostru în punctele de acupunctură, mai mult sau puțin, se transmite această informație a sunetului vibrației a întregului planetei Pământ, a întregului univers prin corpul nostru și, practic, ne ajută să ne recapătăm o memorie ancestrală a universului. Ron, can you just explain a little bit to our audience what is exactly how people can benefit physically and also emotionally, spiritually from different perspectives of having this session with us? Ridica Ron să ne explice în câteva cuvinte cum folosind aceste diapazoane pe corpul nostru, aplicate în aceste puncte de acupunctură, cum putem să beneficiem din punct de vedere fizic, emoțional, spiritual, exact cum ne poate ajuta?
Well, most people in these times are familiar now with acupuncture in some way. And they know that it can be used for all kinds of conditions and that it can be very powerful and very effective. And so Acutonics incorporates that information, that level of information, and opens up the door to the whole system of traditional Chinese medicine, which is vast. You could study it for the rest of this lifetime and several others and still only scratch the surface. So that's the beginning, but as I mentioned, it also, the Acutonic system also incorporates the knowledge and the energy of the heavenly bodies. You could say it incorporates the system of mythology of the planets and of astrology and cosmology as well.
So, Ron, would you say that our memory is preserved in the sound? Întrebarea este, nu se poate spune dacă amintirea noastră, memoriile noastre sunt incorporate în sunet?
The vibrational frequencies are a form of memory. As you know, Michelle, you're a teacher of Awakening the Illuminated Heart as well. And in that workshop, we have people connect with the sacred space of the heart. Because simply by remembering that sound, you can move directly back in to that space at any moment. So yes, sound is a memory. Sound is a bridge. And in the healing work that is done, sound is also a carrier of intention. When we speak of sound as part of the creative principle, sound is the carrier of intention. That is how this whole reality has been created.
Actually, I was very surprised, pleasantly surprised myself trying, a healing session from you, and the information that you receive, the connections that you establish. And I watched other people going through this and how everybody was like, wow. I mean, it's just bringing you to that point of doing wow, because it's so hard to believe that it's possible. Atât eu cât și alte persoane au avut oportunitatea să experimentăm lucrul cu aceste diapazone și să avem o sesiune de la Ron. Și a fost foarte interesant să experimentăm ceea ce înseamnă să reconectăm, să înțelegem, să avem anumite experiențe care te aduc la punctul în care pur și simplu ești fără cuvinte, pentru că experimentezi anumite lucruri pe care poate ți-ar trebui zeci de ani de meditație într-un templu budist ca să înțelegi ce înțelegi doar prin câteva sesiuni de aceste, cu aceste diapazoane. Ron, would you like to tell our viewers a little bit about how you feel that people, once they experience a session, how do they get more interest? Do they want to work more? Do they want to learn more? Do you find that people are open to this new technique, relatively new, because it's not so spread in the world as other teachings or techniques? Rog pe Ron să ne explice câteva cuvinte. Cum mi se pare, care este reacția oamenilor cu care lucrează, atât ca pacienți, și cum simte că acești oameni reacționează și dacă sunt dornici să aibă mai multe sesiuni, dacă simt că se vindecă și dacă sunt interesați să continue și să învețe ei însăși cum să practice acest lucru, mai ales că tehnica cu tonic nu este atât de răspândită în lume ca multe alte tehnici.
Sure. Perhaps to offer some perspective first, I'm not sure of precise numbers, but I'm one of approximately 50 or 60 teachers currently teaching
in the world.
Yes,
okay. So it's currently
teaching the information.
Number.
Yeah, and there are many practitioners who aren't teaching this information but are practicing it. They've been students of the various teachers. I don't know what that number is. I would imagine that it would be a few thousand, which sounds like a large number, but when you think of
7 billion people,
yeah, that's not
yeah.
a lot. Practitioners tend to be really busy. What has happened on many occasions is people who become practitioners of acutonics have commonly had some other form of practice, be it acupuncture, massage, craniosacral, any one of a number of other modalities. And my experience with my students is once they begin practicing acutonics on their clients, at first some of the clients may be skeptical, but more and more as they find out what this can do for them, this becomes the choice of the treatment modalities. And so more and more people begin practicing this in their given healing practice. What can it offer? Everything from a really, really nice, calming, meditative state to profound healing. I've witnessed and experienced both in my practice, and have heard many, many stories from the people who are practicing as my students. I know that's a very general answer, and we can get specific if
you'd
like to.
Well, I can confirm this. Mm-hmm. We brought you to Romania last year for the first time in November, I think, mm-hmm. and you were here for like 4 days.
I believe 4 days of sessions.
Yeah, 4 days of sessions, and we didn't have enough time to put all the people that were willing to experience this. And out of those people, more than half of them decided to take your class, to take your workshop now,
yes.
So they can learn how to do it and practice it with others because of their experience, which was incredible. Anul trecut, în luna noiembrie, am avut onoarea să lucrez pe an în România și am avut 4 zile de sesiuni în care am avut sesiuni libere. Nu am putut să practic să aducem pe toți care au dorit să participe la aceste sesiuni private. Din cei care au participat la aceste sesiuni, mai mult de jumătate s-au înscris la acest workshop pe care l-am ținut în acest weekend, de 5 zile de fapt, și ca să învețe cum să le folosească și cum să le implementeze, fie în practica lor, fie pentru uz personal, în familie și prieteni. Deci rezultatele sunt incredibile în momentul în care experimentez. In the Travelers Workshop, there is a video that we put with Master Zhou, the Qigong Master, and I like him because at the end of that clip it says that most people that come to his practice, they don't believe, but after the treatment, everybody believes. In the workshop pe care îl facem cu Amidramul, Trezirea Inimii Luminate, există câteva clipuri pe care le folosim cu Master Zhou, care este un master de Qigong. Și la întrebarea dacă oamenii cred în ceea ce face el în terapia, lui spune, majoritatea când vin, nu cred. Mă rog, vin să încerce. Dar când după terapie, toată lumea când pleacă, toți cred. Exact așa se întâmplă și aici. Este ceva total deosebit care se produce cu oamenii. Run from all the people that you worked with, how many do you think, because you are working on the spiritual realm, you know, you're just going into spirituality a lot with your work, as well as healing, of course, but how many people do you think they are looking at this practice more from the because of their desire to discover who they are? Because I hear this around me all the time. I want to know. So I think we are in a moment in time where people are so eager to discover their own essence.
Yes.
Întrebarea pentru Ron este, câți dintre cei care vin la el să aibă o sesiune privată sau să învețe să folosească aceste diapazoane, sunt interesați de vindecare, doar de vindecare, de o sesiune de vindecare, și câți dintre ei sunt mai mult îndreptați spre spiritualitate și spre întrebarea pe care toți o avem, cine suntem, de unde venim, care este rostul nostru. Mai ales dacă acum trăim într-un moment unic în istoria universală și se produc anumite schimbări.
Michelle, you know as a teacher, as I do.
I just wanted to tell the viewers.
But you know that
yeah.
What is happening now is that whether it happened 40 years ago or 4 days ago, more and more people are waking up as if from a sleep, a long, long sleep. And when they wake up, that strong desire to find out how things work and why they are the way they are, that wakes up within them. And that's what we have coming into the classes that we give, that kind of intensity. So more and more, this is what is happening on the earth in all places. Romania is remarkable. Just remarkable.
I know.
I don't know if you've stated this before, but there are more teachers of awakening the illuminated heart per capita in Romania than anywhere else in the world.
Yes, yes.
If you had an equivalent amount in the United States, there would be perhaps 100,000 teachers in the U.S. So this is a special case, and there's something going on here.
I'm trying to tell this to Dromlo for a long time. He needs to come to me.
There's something special happening here. And whatever it is, there are many who are asking for information like this. And so this is where we need to come.
One of the things that I noticed with people that I know personally that were part of this workshop, many of them already with me in other workshops, I noticed that, a lot of these people are going through their awakening process. However, in the awakening process, we encounter the problems of the past, the emotional traumas of the past. Which could be, for some people, quite traumatic and quite difficult to overcome. And if you could emphasize a little bit more and just make our viewers understand how many treatments, how many sessions, and during these sessions, is this a smooth process in their healing? Or is something that they need to do for a long time, just so they get a sense if they didn't get a chance to try it yet. And trebuie luat în experiența lui, deoarece a lucrat cu multe persoane care sunt pe un drum de spiritualitate și care au experimentat aceste diapazoane în sesiuni private. În procesul de trezire spirituală, cu toții ne lovim de anumite momente în care ne aducem aminte de trecut. Și aceste reamintiri ne dau uneori anumite momente de tristețe, bucurie, uneori de nebunie. Și cum ne pot asista aceste diapazoane, sunetul, frecvența, vibrația, să ne vindecăm aceste traume emoționale, pentru că la baza tot ceea ce ni se întâmplă nou în această viață, de fapt, sunt traumele emoționale care ne afectează cel mai mult. Și rugăm pe Ron să ne spună cât de ușor, cât de lin, să spunem așa, poate fi vindecarea noastră la acest nivel, folosind diapazoanele, sunetul.
Wow. Well, now the questions are getting pretty hard. There is no set answer for that, Michelle.
I know.
It could be that a single session can really solve the issue that a person came in to work with in a given moment. Or it could be that it may take multiple sessions. My intention each and every time that I work with someone is to have the highest possible healing in that moment. And there are many factors that enter into how effective a given treatment can be. A lot of that has to do with the belief systems that are in play. Things can happen that are truly remarkable given the right conditions. And as you mentioned, many people come in with what we call trauma. And that trauma can be on many levels, physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual. And so a good part of the work is to bring balance in sufficient form that we can begin to have that trauma released. Because it is all about balance. It's a question of balance. That was an album by the Moody Blues many years ago. So when we're working with these instruments, then whether we're doing procedures that are part of an acutonics process or program, or whether we're working with the information of the Fibonacci sequence, all of this is designed to bring the highest possible level of balance back to the individual. When we do that, that begins a process within them. When they're balanced, then emotional, mental, physical, and spiritual human have a foundation. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, that's great. I find out that many people have a difficult time to do that. But so another question that I know it stays with a lot of the people that I know is that this means that all our memories from our past lives are recorded also at the cellular level. Mm-hmm. In our DNA, in our body, in our cells, is the memory of the spirit, one that is descended in this body. It's charging, it's loading all these memories.
Yes.
So through sound, we reconnect.
Yes.
And we can process all this emotion, all these traumas that happened to us in the past. Întrebarea, remarca că o lăsam pe Ransene vorbească, este mulți dintre cei care experimentează cu aceste diapazoane, nu numai că încep să-și aducă aminte, dar încep să proceseze informațiile din care sunt stocate la nivel celular, din viețile trecute. Deci, odată ce spiritul coboară în acest corp fizic, fiecare corp, fiecare celulă din noi magazinează istoria noastră, ceea ce am fost altădată. Și este destul de greu de suportat într-un corp fizic toate traumele pe care un spirit le-a avut de-a parcursul timpului. Și încercăm să determinăm cum, prin sunet, vibrație, folosind aceste diapazoane, putem să efectiv să vindecăm aceste traume emoționale cu care spiritul le aduce în acest corp fizic. Deci, vă lăsa pe Ron să ne explice un pic mai mult. So, we want to just emphasize a little bit on that.
This interview, the picture and the sound of this interview is being recorded, and which means there's a memory that's being held, and that is being held through vibrational frequency. Everything in the electronic realm, the lights in this room, all of this is happening because of a vibrational frequency. My voice is being carried right now through a vibrational frequency. All of that is recorded forever. And so, yes, to access information, we can connect with sound. And as a healing modality, sound then can be used to catalyze the memory and also to bring about a form of balance that allows that memory to be accessed with grace and ease instead of with pain and with trauma. So there are many, many benefits from working with sound as a tool in the healing process. Not everything has to happen with difficulty, with pain. There are times when memory will bring up these issues, but with the correct assistance, the correct level of compassion in treatment, these things can be let go of very quickly, and we move on.
That's fantastic. A question, but with two sides. One, how do you feel that having sessions of acupuncture session, it's helping the spiritual person that is doing a lot of meditation, a lot of inner search, and how fast they can grow by doing sessions such as this? And on the other hand, how do you feel there are people that are not really spiritual? They do believe, but they are not really practicing. And they believe in alternative medicine. And they have certain affections in their body, which some of them know, some of them don't know, that they are bringing them from their past into their present life. And they need to be solving them. So if you can tell me, how is assisting acupuncture both of these categories, those that are really into the spirituality and those that are just looking to understand the problems that they have in their body without it being so much so spiritual.
Sure.
Îl întreb pe Ron cum simte, o întrebare dar are două fațete, cum asistă acest sistem acutonic să lucru cu sunetul pe cei care sunt într-adevăr în spiritualitate, care lucrează în spiritualitate, care caută, care meditează, care coboară înăuntrul lor și își caută acest adevăr interior despre ei și cum simte că îi asistă în cea mai bună modalitate. În același timp, sunt oameni care cred în medicina alternativă, însă nu sunt atât de preocupați de spiritualitate, nu este parte din viața lor de zi cu zi, dar în același timp au credința că există și o altă formă de vindecare. Și știu că Roana a avut câteva sesiuni, câteva numai în București, cu persoane care au avut anumite afecțiuni și aș vrea să ne spună cum a observat el că aceste afecțiuni pot fi vindecate chiar și la cei care nu sunt pe un drum spiritual.
Okay. What comes to mind for me in answer to that is an old saying there that perhaps will translate as well. It is, all roads lead to Rome. And of course, we're in Romania. Rome is in another country. But in this case, all roads lead to Om. Om is the foundational vibration of the reality. And it doesn't matter if you're spiritual or not. When you hear that sound, it takes you somewhere. And it connects at a very deep level. And so, as people connect to that sound, it can catalyze a spiritual awareness and movement. Or, with someone who has no background or even desire, it still touches something within them that goes very deep. Whether or not we have consciously begun our journey on the spiritual realm in this life, we still are spiritual beings. And that being the case, the sound of Om will have a profound effect.
That is amazing. You know, you said something and I remember the saying that is absolutely amazing, that we are not humans having a spiritual experience, but we are spirits having a human experience. Într-adevăr, vreau să aminte acum de un citat care spune că nu suntem oameni cu experiență spirituală, ci suntem spirite cu experiență umană. Și atunci când ne aducem aminte acest lucru, lucrurile se transformă pentru totdeauna în viața noastră. I think when we understand that, everything turns around 180 degrees in everybody's life.
Yes.
When we understand that we are not just human passing by this planet, just by mistake, by chance.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, Ron, when you know, our viewers, we talk to them about this now, and maybe everybody would like to do a class with you, but you're leaving. So, would you be interested to come back to Romania and have another workshop and work with more people? And what are your plans for the future?
Mm-hmm.
How did you feel the audience that you had here in Romania? O să ne întrebăm pe Ron acum dacă, bazat pe experiența pe care a avut-o în România, acum ar fi de-a doua oară aici și ținând acest workshop, dacă va fi dispus să vină din nou, când, și mai ales fiind convins că vom trezi curiozitatea multora dintre voi cu acest discurs despre, prezentare despre Acutonics și chiar o să vă invităm poate în viitor la o sesiune introductivă. Actually, maybe we can do another introductory evening next time, mm-hmm. if you decide to come back.
I would love to do that. Michelle, my life for the past number of years has been much like a wandering mendicant. I go where I'm invited and where I feel there is an opening for the information that I can offer. And here in Romania, there is a sincere desire. And so when I feel that invitation, I have to come. And I love to come. So yes, we are already planning another event. And it will be an honor to come back to Romania.
Okay, great, wonderful, I'm happy.
Is anything else that you feel that you want to transfer as a message to the audience that maybe we didn't get a chance to ask you? Mm-hmm. Nimic pe rând, dacă are un mesaj pe care dorește să-l transmite și care nu a fost, pe care nu l-am întrebat, să vă exprime tuturor ceea ce simte și
Ron? Ready?
Yes.
Don't worry, be happy.
I mean, you'd like to tell them where is that coming from? I think it's a little something that everybody would enjoy to meditate on that. Yeah.
Words of a master from India who took a vow of silence. Mayur Bala is his name. Took a vow of silence and for many, many years remained in silence until finally he let his followers know that he was going to offer to speak to them with his voice. And when his followers from all over the world found that out, many of them traveled to India to hear him speak directly. Many who had never heard a word from him. And so he had all of these people gathered there. And he came up on stage and said, "Don't worry, be happy." And that was it. After that, he went back into silence. Profound words.
Very profound words, and I would like to say that also working with a lot of people, I found out that people are looking so much outside, outside of them, to receive from somebody else, to be taught by somebody else. I actually met somebody that was extremely upset that their master didn't do more for them, didn't give them, didn't feed them like pills with knowledge. And it's hard for people sometimes to understand that everything comes from within. The truth and its inner search is not from outside. And yes, you can take knowledge and information from outside. It's up to you to process it and understand it. So that is, I think, in a way, in my experience, the tuning forks did just that for me. It helped me kind of consolidate everything that I had, information, and I knew it because I absorb it. But once that I was doing sessions with this, it helped me process it from within. And it was the most incredible thing that happened to me. So, doresc să spun că sunt mulți oameni care așa cum spunea Mayur Bala, exemplul lui Mayur Bala, este că căutăm răspunsurile în afara noastră. Cunosc chiar oameni care sunt foarte supărați pe maestrii lor, că nu le dau mai mult, mai mult, mai mult. Oamenii parcă așteaptă o pilulă cu cunoaștere și atunci când mă primesc, când o reschid sau când crede că au nevoie, sunt supărați pe maestrii lor. Fără să înțeleagă cu adevărat că, de fapt, cunoașterea poți să o primești. Primești informația, deci să la latitudinea noastră să o procesăm înăuntru nostru. Nimic, niciodată, nu va veni din afară. Accesăm în afară, dar adevăratul adevăr îl găsim numai înăuntru nostru. Și spuneam că am primit și eu foarte mult din afară, am avut noroc de maestri deosebit, sau poate noroc, nu am avut noroc, așa pot să-i întâlnesc, dar adevărata redescoperire am găsit-o înăuntru meu. Iar aceste sesiuni cu, prin terapia sunetului m-au ajutat să conștientizez și să trezesc să toată această cunoaștere pe care am adus-o înăuntru să o conștientizez într-un mod total diferit, să prindă o viață a ei proprie. Și vă invit pe toți cei care urmăriți această emisiune, dacă aveți ocazia în viitor, să experimentați o sesiune de terapie prin sunet. Vor fi viitorul nostru prieten de persoane care au făcut acest workshop și vor, pe care unii dintre voi poate chiar îi cunoașteți, care vor oferi, să sperăm, sesiuni și altor oameni interesați. Dar oricum Ron va fi înapoi în România în curând și vom face așa fel ca să știți când va veni și probabil că vom face o sesiune introductivă care să deschidă o poartă pentru cei, toți cei dornici să înțeleagă, să cunoască, să redescopere mai mult din cine sunt din cu adevărat. Just to let you know, I added to that and I said that it would be an honor to have you back, and we will have make sure that we make an announcement so people that are viewing this show, they'll have the opportunity to come to an introductory evening and see for themselves, discover, think about it to see if this is something that they would like to experience either in a session or as a workshop. And also I think that I told them that as we do this workshop there will be more and more people that will be able to practice this, and some of the viewers already know some of the people that participated in the workshop, so in a long run there will be availability for them to take sessions with other people that they are training to do this, and since they cannot have availability to you all the time, so we'll see. So maybe now we'll try to do a little bit of a demonstration and to see exactly how, as much as we can through the, since we are not live in person next to each audience member, but to see if they can get a little bit of a sense of the sound of the tuning force and the difference in sound in the tonality and the octave of sound. Deoarece nu avem oportunitatea să fim live pe scenă cu toți cei care ne urmăresc, vom face o mică demonstrație să vedeți impactul pe care aceste sunete îl au de la diverse frecvențe, diverse tonalități, în măsura în care este posibil prin intermediul acestui interviu program.
So how do you propose to do that?
Ah, I would like to sing it, but I can't. So I think we're gonna get closer to the camera to see if it can capture the best way the sound,
sure.
Because it may not travel pretty well at distance.
We'll have to be close to a microphone.